I got news.
Hello, all my wonderful people, and welcome back to the Podunk Weekly Chronicle. I have missed you. I apologize for missing last week, but real life reared its ugly head, and medical issues and lack of motivation kind of stifled me from making any content for the channel. But I am back, and I have news for you. Let's dive right in. First up, we have a game update, and there has been 2 weeks worth of progress made, particularly on my little pet project that's... Oh, I'm so excited about this one. And that's Black Screen Simulator. I'm right there. You can see it's been a good chunk on that production meter. We are right near the end of production. We'll be going into alpha state, brief beta period for testing, and then I'll be unleashing this on the world, hopeful for this month. But there is one big last hurdle that I need to overcome, and it's kind of the linchpin for this game, going from meme to mind. And then, speaking of new stuff, I am hoping for this Friday I'll be debuting a new series on this channel. Given YouTube's recent change of you need to hit 10,000 views before you can become a partner, and the way we really like you to do views is if you do daily content, I'm going to be debuting a hopefully daily possible new series. I want to get a few more. I want to try this trial run of the pilot and get a few episodes in the can before I go daily on it. And it's called Who Are the 19? I don't want to give too much away from this. You know, I'm a magician. I want to give you the prestige moment when he actually gets out. Keep a lookout for that on Friday. And then tomorrow, the Fables of Rongedale get a little bit longer as we add a new story, The Testament of Oceana. Which trials are coming to Ungadale? This time they're being headed up by the dwarfs, so be on the lookout for that. It's free for people on Wattpad, and for those that are supporting me directly, it'll be an update for the book on Amazon and Google Books. And speaking of support, a new segment to the program, we have Patreon shoutouts. I want to give a big special shoutout to the people that are keeping my wonderful weird world free, and that would be Elvish Nerding and Jesse Michelle. Thank you both so much. And if you do like my content, if you liked anything I've done so far, and you want access to all this free, as well as the chance to get some t-shirts, some paintings, and a postcard story, please do check out patreon.com/dustyofpodunk. And to wrap this week, we're going to dive into another segment of Dear Dusty. For those of you unfamiliar, Dear Dusty is a Q&A segment where any question, any topic, I just ask you keep it safe for work. So first up this week, we have favorite game to play, and that's asked by Samphoria. Now, I had to have a think about this one. Favorite game to play. I had to separate that from my favorite game, because while I do have a favorite game, and if that question's fully up for anyone to ask, my favorite game to play is one I come back to every year or so, and that would be Seasons 2 and 3 of Telltale Sam & Max, Beyond Space and Time, and particularly The Devil's Playhouse. I've played through all 10 of those games at least once a year for like the past 5 years. They just make me happy, and they're modern day adventure games done so well. Next up, Miss Valerie Mayo asks, what was the first drawing or painting of? I can't remember the first thing I ever drew. It was probably a hand turkey, like all of us learned how to draw, where you stencil your hand. But as far as my more generalized paintings, that would have been about a year ago last month, and I think the first one was either a wolf or it was a forest. And that really kicked off me doing a new painting. At one time, it was 3 new paintings every day. Kind of had to slow down on that, but that's a story for another time. Jinjar247 asks, what game world would you like to live in, and who would you be? Now, I have to be completely honest with you. I overthought this one, and I'm going to give you a very, very vanilla answer. I know most people see it like, oh, I want to go live in Skyrim. I want to go be the Witcher. I want to go be Master Chief. Those are foolish answers made by foolish people. The problem with those answers is, okay, let's say you're the Witcher. Let's say you're going to live in Skyrim. You're living in a medieval world. There is no indoor plumbing. There is no internet. If you go be Master Chief, you are getting shot at. There's a high possibility you will die. But, and here's where I had some thinking. My series I would choose would be Assassin's Creed, but I'd want to be like a mid-level engineer working for Abstergo, so I could basically be one of the guys who gets plugged into an Animus and gets to relive out an ancestor's memories, so I could be pretty much playing a video game at work. And as I understand it, and please no spoilers to anyone, I believe they completely abandoned the overarching secondary plot for those games, so I'd have a nice steady job of just, you know, going and being in the Renaissance or the French Revolution or anything like that. And finally, JD asks, perfect sandwich. This is a deeply personal question. This is one we all have to answer and look deep inside ourselves. And when I look deep inside myself, I see a hankering for what we call pulled or shredded meat. Big fan of things like pulled pork, pulled chicken, shredded beef. So my perfect sandwich would probably be... I'm gonna lean towards probably a pulled pork or a nice shredded Philadelphia cheesesteak. Just thinking about that makes me really hungry. But that is all the time I have for this week in the Podunk Weekly Chronicle. Please do subscribe. I am on the road to 100. If I hit 100 subscribers, I will be doing a cover of Carry On My Wayward Son. Please do like, because that will help me out. And given that I do still need to hit 10,000 views, please do share this video around if you enjoyed it. Until next time, I hope you all stay wonderful, and thanks for stopping by in Podunk.